This is really the story of the regeneration of a man. The action takes place in an old English castle in dear old England. As the curtain rises, we learn that Dudu, short for Lord Dumont Doolittle, is getting married on the morrow. Now, it is true that on the occasion of his bachelor dinner, only ladies are present, but this is because he is bidding them all a final and definite farewell.
I'm saying goodbye, May, goodbye, Fay. You know why I'm leaving. Goodbye, Bess, goodbye, Jess. Stop your sighs and grieving. All those pretty tears you're shedding, wipe away. For my pals shall be gay on my wedding day. I must say goodbye, Nell, goodbye, Belle. Don't you tell on me, dear, goodbye, you. And you too, please take back your key, dear. Sweeter than you should to me. You've all been awfully good to me. Goodbye, 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 girls. Mwah.
That's the end of the first scene. As the second scene begins, we find Dudu standing at the sideboard enjoying a typical English breakfast. Suddenly, there is a knock at the door. It is Lady Millicent, his fiancée. She enters. Ah, Millicent, he says, as fair in English you are, with your English hair and your English skin and the damp of the downs and your shaggy tweeds. But Lady Millicent holds up her hand for silence.
Hush, Dudu, darling, listen to what I have to say. How am I to begin? I can't, and yet I must. Very well, then, here it is. I love another. There, it's out. I love another. I've said it. I'm glad. You quite understand. I wonder. I love another. It's like a joyous hymn in my breast. My pagan heart won't stop singing. I love another. I love another. I love another.
You love another?
I love another.
His name?
His name is Right Honorable Reginald Percival Archibald Algernon Brankable Constable Uricle Smythe.
Binky Smythe?
Binky Smythe.
Binky? Well, I can't believe. Why, he's my best friend. Binky?
Binky? Oh, Dudu, darling, I know what you must be thinking, so before I go, all I can say to you is, follow, follow your heart.
Shattered, destroyed, as in a thousand pieces, Dudu contemplates ending it all by leaping out the window, but he changes his mind and rings for Frippins, the old family butler. Frippins enters.
You rang, sir?
Yes, Frippins, I rang. What am I to do? Lady Millicent, who once played a troth to me, is now playing a troth to another. What on earth am I to do?
If you will take the advice of a very old butler, sir, you will get on the next boat train to Paris, and there you will fall in love with the very next girl that you will see.
An excellent suggestion, Frippins. That's precisely what I shall do. I'm off to Paris, and then I shall fall in love with the very next girl that I see. The very next girl I see will be the right girl for me. The first alarming, charming niece that I discover, I'm going to woo her, go right to her, say I love her. Later on that day, strolling down the Champs-Élysées, Dudu comes across a little cafe, and in it there's a little chanteuse. At the end, she is singing,
Voulez-vous, rendez-vous, avec moi.
And he does. Later on in her little flat overlooking the flower markets of Paris, she tells him what is in her heart. Oh, Dudu, chérie, je t'adore. Dudu, dearie, I love you. J'ai besoin de toi. I have need of you.
Hello, Dudu.
Hello, Dudu. And again he does. He takes her in his arms. He's about to crush her lips with his when suddenly those eyes, that mouth, that face. No, it can't be. Yes, it is. The image of Lady Millicent come to haunt him in his dreams. Realizing now that he can never love another woman, he decides to end it all by leaping out the window. And he does.